Many governments have spent hundreds of billions of dollars exploring space. But how much do we really know about our own planet? We've measured it by earthquake, we've flown around it, we've sailed around it, we've drilled into it. But we don't really know how the Earth is built, what gives it its magnetosphere, why we're able to live on the surface of our world. So in July of 2007, we will undertake the greatest geological expedition in the history of the world, here, to the North Pole, to discover if the Earth is in fact hollow. Join us. It is written, many are called, but few are chosen. I like to think of it a little differently. Many are called, but few choose. I've been chosen to lead the North Pole Inner Earth Expedition. My name is Brooks Agnew, and I choose to start here. Mount Shasta, at 9,000 feet, shrouded in the mists of mystery. To begin what may be the greatest geological expedition in the history of the world. To discover if the Earth is hollow or not. Join us. You may ask, who am I that I should lead this most intrepid group of people on this expedition? Well, I have been privileged with the highest callings there are, that of teacher, scientist, engineer, talk show host of X Squared Radio, but most of all, I am an Earth explorer. My family came to Scotland from ancient lands in the 13th century and founded Stranraer and the lands called Galloway. They built this magnificent castle overlooking Loch Na high in the hills above the western coast. The Agnew clan served as magistrates over land transfers. In the early 15th century, the Ross clan sold a tract of land to the Sinclairs from France. The chapel at Rosslyn is one of the most famous centers of holy power on Earth. It is believed that the Ark of the Covenant once was housed here. A most remarkable history is preserved behind these doors. The Agnews were the hereditary sheriffs of Galloway, Knights of Christ, who protected Rosslyn Chapel from plunder for over 350 years. The symbols are cross-fertilized between Agnew Castle and Rosslyn Chapel. The Scottish Cross, the Templar's Square, and the Flowers of Life adorn both buildings. The Agnew-Ross bloodline is preserved through one living heir, yours truly. Why hollow earth theory? How was it formulated? Over the years, we've collected space data using satellite photography, using orbiting experiments. We've also collected earth-based data by examining evidence on the ice, evidence in the sky, evidence in the sea, evidence from earthquakes, and finally, from human consciousness itself. What we have learned about the Earth is that there is enough supporting data to support a theory that the Earth may in fact be hollow. Most of us are familiar with our world as we view it from weather satellites on the evening news. These satellites go around the planet from east to west or from west to east. There are a few satellites called polar satellites that go around the Earth, North and South Pole. However, data is not available to the public.
for a view of the North Pole or the South Pole, only the center section. That's about to change. In July of 2007, we will undertake the greatest geological expedition in the history of the world. We'll bring the data back to you from the North Pole.
There are only a few polar satellites. In February of 2006, the federal government issued a data denial implementation plan, which secures the continued flow of real-time meteorological satellite data from the NOAA, provided instruments on board EUMETSAT's METCOP spacecraft to public duty users in the United States. During episodes that might otherwise require data denial means real-time data from U.S. environmental instruments can be denied during periods of crisis or war. There are no publicly available images of the North Pole.
When a solar flare occurs, cosmic radiation leaps out into space, crossing the distance from the sun to the Earth in about 73 hours. As it approaches the planet, it can often form an aurora borealis, also known as the northern lights, ribbons of light as cosmic radiation turns into light above our planet, approaching from the north or the south pole of our planet. But what would cause an aurora borealis to form over both poles at the same time? Find out as we explore our world in 2007 during the North Pole Inner Earth Expedition.
In this slide of space photography, one can see the city lights blurred below as the beautiful blue-green aurora borealis is captured with a solar wind passing gracefully around the planet Earth. Solar flares explode from the sun's surface hundreds of thousands of miles into space. These emit X-rays, high-energy particles, and gamma rays that travel on a solar wind to Earth in about 73 hours. The Earth's magnetosphere is generated by the crust rotating around a solid metallic core. Without this magnetosphere, the surface of the Earth would be completely sterilized. Unlike traditional gravity theories, gravity actually centers in the crust of the Earth. Are there openings in the Earth's crust that lead to an interior world? We are about to explore and find out. Originally, as the Earth formed from particles surrounding the Sun in what's called an accretion disk, the Earth formed in a ball and exhibited a condition called overspin. As the crust expanded, the Earth slowed down to its present rate. What is left behind is a gap between the core and the crust. Molten rock fills in the gaps left by the expansion of Earth's crust. Earth was once one-third its present diameter. It's easily seen that all of the continents once fit together like a key and a lock. The crust has expanded enough so that now ocean fills in the space between the continents. One can see from this graph that in the last 25 years, earthquakes have increased in intensity and frequency. The rate of increase is alarming. Every time there is a major earthquake, geologists collect an MRI of the Earth That is to say, vibrations travel from the point of earthquake to the other side of the planet, where precision accelerometers reveal a detailed picture of what the Earth may look like on the inside. Unfortunately, each time one of these events occurs, there is a series of shadow waves, or unexplained waves, left behind. This example, out of a common textbook, is exactly what geological students see each year. Each time, they have to accommodate the shadow zone. We believe this is a broken model, as does Jan Lambrecht, who also took the same math data and worked it backwards to see if the MRI could reveal the true structure of the inner Earth. In this slide, you can see there is a model that works without exception, every time. As the vibration occurs on one side of the planet, it passes through the crust, but does not pass through the open air area between the crust and the core. Instead, it passes freely around, reflecting to the other side. There are no shadow zones in this model. The math works perfectly every time. In actuality, as the Earth forms, it forms into a sphere rather than a solid ball. The center of gravity, as shown here, is actually in the middle of the crust. Think of it as if you were standing in an elevator on a bathroom scale, and the elevator traveled to the center of the Earth from the surface. As you went lower and lower, your body weight would actually drop until, when you finally reached the center of the Earth, your body weight might actually be negative. According to Newtonian physics, as matter coagulates or aggregates in space, the amount of gravity associated with that mass increases with its weight. If those Newtonian physics are, in fact, accurate, while you're in the center of the Earth, you would actually weigh nothing, because all of the mass of the Earth would be above you. This is why planets form into spheres and not solid balls. In actuality, the acceleration of gravity that we feel on the surface is about 32 feet per second squared. However, standing on the inside of the crust, as though you were standing in China, only on the inside of the Earth, the acceleration would be about a third less, or about 21 feet per second squared. The open air gap between the inside of the crust and what many theorists believe is an inner sun may be as much as 1,200 miles of open air. To put that in perspective, the space shuttle flies at about 200 miles above the surface of the Earth. High-altitude aircraft fly at about 8 miles above the planet. We have about 3 miles of breathable atmosphere on the surface of our planet, whereas in the inner Earth, there may be as much as 800 to 1,000 miles of breathable atmosphere. The inner sun may be a glowing ball of metal, providing inner heat and a soft glow for the interior of the Earth. Without a sundown event, there would be no night or day on the inner Earth, simply a soft twilight 24 hours a day. A temperature equilibrium may form, with a minimum of weather. However, with a vast atmosphere, a tropical environment, low in solar radiation, may form the perfect environment for long life and giantism among plants and animals. The idea behind a North Pole passage is that there is a hole or an opening in the crust equalizing the pressure from the interior to the exterior of the planet. The ocean actually coats the crust on the inside and outside of the crust, meaning that there is an outer ocean upon which we sail and an inner ocean, an ocean with no horizon. What we are about to undertake in July of 2007 may be the greatest geological expedition in the history of the world. The builders of Roslyn Chapel in the year 1442
wanted us to know the true nature of the earth. Directly above the altar, in the center front of the chapel, in the ceiling, lowered down and carefully ornately carved, a hollow world with an interior sun. Join our expedition, the North Pole Inner Earth Expedition, leaving July 4th, 2007. Our project cost is estimated to be around $2 million. The Phoenix Science Foundation is a nonprofit organization organized to manage this event, along with Advanced Scientific Explorations, LLC. Our mission statement is to build a team with the right skills and the right consciousness to reunite the human race with their family in the inner earth and beyond. The Phoenix Science Foundation, a nonprofit organization in cooperation with Advanced Scientific Explorations, LLC, has formed this expedition to bring the film, the data, and the samples back from the North Pole so that you will know whether the world is in fact hollow or not.